So is Google Flights the best website to use when you're trying to find the absolute best prices available and the cheapest flights available? Let's take a look and find out. Hey, welcome back, everybody. I am Linda Jones from Crafted Travel Company, and today I'm going to give you a Google Flights review and tutorial, as well as some secret hacks to make sure you're getting the absolute best prices on your next flight and the cheapest prices on your next flight. So Google Flights, if you aren't aware, is not an actual booking engine. What they do is they take the airline prices from just about every airline in the world, and they consolidate it into one place so that you can look and see if you're going to a certain destination, what flights are available and what the prices are, so you can easily compare and find the absolute cheapest price. Not only do they consolidate all that information, but because they have access to all of that information, it is a great place to go as well to decide where you want to go. They have some great features that let you explore the entire world and, based on what price you're willing to spend, decide where you want to go next. It's fantastic for inspiration. So, does it fall short anywhere? Is it really the best place to go versus Skyscanner and Momondo and Expedia and all those places? Well, let's go ahead and jump in and let me show you what it does, and let's decide if it's the best one for you. Now, I'm gonna just give you a quick walkthrough so that you understand kind of the basics of how it works, and then I'm gonna jump into the secret hacks to make sure you're getting the absolute best and cheapest airfare available. So it's pretty self-explanatory. You simply plug in where you wanna go. Let's just say we're going from Los Angeles, and let's just say we want to go to London, and we're gonna go to Heathrow, and I'll just keep the dates the way they are. You click search. And here it brings up all of your available options. They always highlight the cheapest price in green. But one of the things you want to look at is notice that it has three stops. So you want to make sure that you're looking at those deals before you book them and decide, okay, is it worth it for me to save a couple hundred dollars or $100 to have three stops? You need to decide that. So then what you would do is say you wanted to take this flight, you simply click the down arrow. If that looks like something you're interested in, you say select flight. That takes it care of your outgoing flight. Then now you need to choose your returning flight. To keep the same price, you would have to go with this one. Though you do have the options of picking one of the other ones, they just would be more expensive. But let's go ahead and say we're gonna stick with the cheapest flight. We would select this returning flight. And then it tells you where to go to book it. So as I said, Google Flights is not a booking engine. This just consolidates all of the information, shows it to you so you can compare, and then tells you where you can go to book it. So the cool thing about that is they aren't invested in where you book it. They are kind of neutral about it. So they aren't trying to push you to book one thing over the other. So if this was the actual flight you were wanting to take, you would simply go, and sometimes there's multiple booking options available. For this particular one, it's just the one from Kiwi.com. So you would select that, it takes you to Kiwi.com, and then you complete your booking like you normally would. So that is just the basic way to walk through Google Flights. Let's go ahead back to the beginning. And let me show you some of the secret tips and tricks and hacks to make sure you're getting the absolute cheapest airfare. Okay, so one of the first things I want to show you is when you know where you're leaving from, but you're not really sure where you want to go, you can actually leave this blank. And when you search for the dates that you're interested in, it will actually bring up a map of the entire world, and it will help you get inspiration for what your options are. So let me go ahead and back out of here so it shows us the entire globe. And then you can set your price. Let's say we want to spend $300 on our flight. What it does is it takes all of the flights available on July 16th to July 20th in this situation, but you can see how you can narrow it by your price point, and it'll give you inspiration, let you know what your options are so that you can make that right choice. Okay, so on that note, the other thing that you can do is say you know you want to go to Europe, but you're not sure where you want to go. You can simply put in Europe, and it will do the exact same thing and let you know what your options are in Europe. So this is kind of cool because if you say, okay, I want to go to Europe, but I want to do it the cheapest, it's easy to take a look at all of Europe and say, okay, my options to keep it the cheapest, it looks like I can get there for, oh gosh, Copenhagen for $728, Athens, Looks like some other places. So if you just simply want to get to Europe and then explore from there, this is a really easy way to find who, where you can go the cheapest and then expand from there. So it's not just Europe that you can see. You can do this. You can say, I want to go to South America. I want to go to Asia. I want to go, you know, to a specific, say, Canada, and then it'll show you all of the cheapest flights in Canada, North America. It's a really cool way to, if you know the basic area you want to go, find the cheapest flight within that basic area that you'd like to go. One of the other things that you can do is you can search up to 5 departure airports as well as up to 5 destination airports. So let's say you live in LA. So your options, you want to say, I'm going to go to LAX. And it's good to know your 3-digit codes. Simply Google that if you aren't sure what your 3-digit code is for your airport. In my case, it's LAX. Orange County is SNA. Long Beach is LGB. Where else can I go? I can go to Burbank, which is BUR. And you know what? I live in Orange County, so I could even drive down to San Diego. So let's go ahead and check those. And then let's go back and say, let's say I want to go to Europe again. Okay, so you can say, okay, I want to take this Copenhagen flight, and it'll come over here and it'll tell you, okay, this one's from LAX. If there were cheaper in San Diego or Orange County or any of those places, it would show up here as the top in the green, and it would say which airport that you're doing. This just expands your search so you have more opportunity to find the absolute cheapest prices available. Okay, so that covers some options, ways to open up your options as far as where you're leaving from and where you're going into. And if you saw my video on how to find the cheapest prices, the key to that is to be flexible on your dates as well as flexible on your airports. So how can you be flexible on your dates? Well, there's a couple ways. Let's look. So how do you keep your dates open and find the cheapest date? Well, there's two ways to do it. The first is if you know where you want to go. So say you do, you definitely know, I want to go to London, period, the end, that's for sure where I'm going. You can actually do it right here in the top screen. So you would put in London, oops, that's the wrong thing, London. And then they actually have a very robust calendar system that shows you the dates. So you can simply scroll through and decide the cheapest rates. So if you wanted to go to in July, it looks like leaving July 25th is going to be your cheapest option. But if you keep scrolling, it'll actually populate the cheapest prices for each month. And you can simply scroll through and make some decisions on when you want to go based on what the cheapest dates are. So that is how you do it if you already know where you want to go, the actual city that you want to go to. But what if you just say, okay, I want to go to Europe, but I don't know when, then what I recommend is you come down here to explore destinations. Now, this is amazing if you're just wanting to be inspired for your next vacation and you want to find something cheap and get to the places you want to see, this is where I recommend you go. So you hit explore destinations. All right, so we're gonna keep it broad. We're gonna go back to saying we wanna go to Europe. I only know I wanna go to Europe and that's all there is to it. But here's the cool thing. If you click here, it will search the next 6 months if you wanna keep it that broad, or if you wanna narrow it down to a specific month, you're certainly welcome to. And then it will also check how long you want to be gone so it can find the best combination of flights so that you can be gone. So like if you want to be gone 7 days, it'll say, okay, well you need to leave on this date and this date is the best combination. Or if you want to be gone 2 weeks, okay, this date and this date is the best combination. It'll actually search it for you. So let's say we want to just have them search all the next 6 months and I want to actually go for 2 weeks because, you know, we're going to Europe, we want to stay and actually see some stuff. So we search for that. And now what it's going to do is pull up all of those combinations and let you know the absolute cheapest date. So before when we were searching in July, we were finding about $700 being the cheapest. But now that we've opened it up and been flexible on our dates and our location, look, we're finding actually some as low as $400. So let's say, okay, I just want to get to Europe. I'm going to go to Dublin and so I can get into the continent as cheap as possible and explore from there. So I'm gonna say Dublin. So now is where you come over here and you can find out, okay, so when do I need to leave in order to have this cheapest flight? And you can see over here, these are your options for what airlines to take. And up here, this is the combination they found that will give you the absolute cheapest rate to fly to Dublin. So that's how you can find the cheapest combination of both dates and locations as well. Okay, so say you've done all of that research and you've discovered, okay, I wanna go to Dublin and I wanna go on those cheapest dates. So I wanna show you a few other hacks to actually get it even better, to have more opportunity to save even more money. So let's say we're gonna go to LA, we're gonna stick to Dublin because we found that that was the cheapest time to go. And I believe it was November 18th to December 2nd. So we're going to go here and search. Okay, so now from this screen, once you've done your initial searching, there's a few little secret hacks that you can use to get cheaper airfare. The first is that I wanna show you is track prices. So if you toggle this on, what it's going to do is it's going to watch a flight to Dublin from LAX around the timeframe, or actually for the exact dates that you're looking for, and it'll send you notifications anytime the price changes. So if it goes up, it'll let you know. If it goes down, it'll let you know so that you can go ahead and jump on buying it when it's at its absolute lowest. The other thing that you can do, I'm gonna toggle this back off, is you can go to the date grid and find out other combinations. So if you say, okay, well, that's great, but I can't leave on the 18th. What other dates can I leave that might still give me the cheapest dates? So these are the leave departure dates, these are the return dates, and it's just a simple grid so that you can help find your cheapest combination. So if you leave on Saturday and come back December 3rd, you can still get that cheapest flight available. That's a neat way to look at it. If you're more of a graph kind of person, it simply shows you the price based on your departure if you wanna see it in a grid format and see overall these next few weeks, which one's cheaper God, I cannot talk today. It'll show you visually which one is cheaper so you can decide when to go. And then airports, this is very cool because this, if you didn't, say you're leaving from LA and you didn't click all of the LAs, you didn't put in all of the airports around LA, but you wanna go back and still check and see if there's anybody cheaper, any airports cheaper, both where you're leaving from and where you're going, this is where you do it. You click on airports, and actually, if you're not in this screen already, you simply click here where it says nearby airports, and you can click both your destination airports and your origin, where you're leaving from. So say I forgot to put in Orange County and San Diego and all those places, I can go in here and now add them. I can add Burbank and John Wayne is Orange County and San Diego, and it'll automatically check those out for me. The other thing I can do is check the destination airports to see, is there any other airports near Dublin? There's other airports in Ireland and in Scotland and in England that might be cheaper than Dublin. So let's take a look at that. So I'm gonna say destination airports. So Dublin is, as we know, the 476. The cool thing about it is if I just hover over, like for instance, Cork, it shows me how far it would be. So if I chose to go into Cork, it says, okay, well, it would take you about 3 hours to get back to Dublin. And if I wanted to do that, I could definitely do that. But the other cool thing is it shows you the price. So you can simply scroll through and say, okay, anybody cheaper, and nobody's cheaper. So you can leave it. But there's been times when I have come onto here and say, for instance, I was going to fly into London Heathrow, and I looked and I actually found that I could save $200 by flying into Gatwick. So it's always worth looking at this just to make sure you're getting the absolute cheapest combination between your origin airport where you're leaving from and your destination airport where you're going into. Okay, so back to this, one of the other little tricks I wanna make sure that you know about is if you come up here to more and make sure you're saying show separate tickets. So one of the other ways that you can save a lot of money is if you book 2 one-way tickets rather than a round trip airfare. Now, this isn't always the case, but sometimes you can actually find cheaper 2 one-ways than you can in a round trip fare. And the cool thing that I like and why Google Flights is my favorite website to go to when I'm booking flights is because they do it automatically for you. You just wanna make sure it's saying show separate tickets. Now, if this ticket came up and these are all round trip, but if it was separate tickets, it would be highlighted in red over on this side here, and it would say separate tickets. So that way, when you went to book it, you wouldn't get confused. You would understand, okay, I need to book this ticket and then go and book this ticket. And it would walk you through, but at least you would understand what you were doing and that you were getting the best rate through having 2 one-way fares. Okay, so back to the main screen. Some of the other tricks here is always, if you look for the green, it'll always show you what the cheapest flight is. And say we wanted to do this one on Air Canada, but it's also available on United and Lufthansa. And what you do is it will give you anything, any information that you really need to know. One of the things you also want to check is your connection time. If you do have a stopover, you want to make sure that your layover is long enough that you can do what you need to do. If you're flying internationally, if you're flying into a huge airport where there's chances are you're going to have to go a long distance between terminals, if you're gonna have to go through customs, you want to make sure there's enough time built into your layover so that you can amply get to all of the places you need to get to and not miss your flight. So an hour and 36 minutes is kind of tight, actually, if you're flying internationally. So you would want to decide whether you want to gamble on that type of the time frame or not. So always check that. And then other things you want to check is, you know, overnight, if you have to prepare for that, making sure that if you're flying for 10 hours, you have in-seat power, you know, Wi-Fi, if there's meals, things like that. So you can always get all of that information here. Now, as you know, if you've flown any time recently, there are actually multiple levels of economy class. You have economy basic, which means you typically don't get an assigned seat. You don't get any carry-on luggage available. You basically, it's the cheapest of the cheapest of the cheapest, and the service kind of matches that. Or you can do economy, kind of standard main cabin economy, or you can do economy premium economy. Now, one of the things about Google Flights is it doesn't necessarily show you that on this screen, but if you go through all the way as if you're gonna book this ticket, it'll give you more details. On that note, say I wanted to go ahead and take this cheapest one on Air Canada, I would say select flight. Here it's gonna give me my best returning flights based on price. So if I wanted to keep this Air Canada at this price, I could, but if I wanted to change it, if I liked another time better, I could. It would just let you know what the price difference would be. For our purposes, let's just go ahead and keep this one, because what I wanna find out is exactly what class of service this is, so I know what I'm getting myself into. So I'm gonna say select flight. And then this is the combination. So here is where you find out. So this $476 price is the basic airfare. So you would have to pay to get your seat selection, you would have to pay to get extra leg room, and you would have to pay to be able to check a bag. But if you find, see, if you take the $476 plus $140, if you had to check a bag, it would be cheaper just to get your standard economy instead and get your checked bag for free. So this clearly shows you what your options are. If you'd like to go up to a higher level of service, it also shows you what premium economy would be as well. And then once you've decided that, say you're fine with the absolute basic, it'll show you where to go to book them, where you're gonna get the cheapest price. And in this case, it looks like booking directly with Air Canada or Lufthansa will give you the absolute best price. And when you click it, it sends you to that website for booking. Okay, let's go back. So say we're on this flight. One of the other things I wanna show you, one of the other last little tips and tricks, is before you press select and buy, always check this little box right here, because it'll let you know, is 42 low for the time period? Is it high? If it's up here in the red, it's too high and you might want to wait for the lower price, or if it's in the middle, it might go up or it might go down. So one of the things you always want to check is it a good time to buy or not? Because that could actually save you hundreds of dollars. As you can see, if it were high right now, you would be spending more than $1,000 over what you could be getting it for. And if you want to go farther, you can click this price history and it can kind of give you an idea of what prices have been doing. So if it's been extremely volatile over the last few days, then you know, and it's low right now, you might want to go ahead and buy it right now. And so you can prevent the volatility of the price going up drastically before you're ready to buy it. Okay, and one more thing before we leave this screen, I want to make sure that you're noticing the checked bag fee here so that you know what you're getting yourself into with regards to if you're gonna be bringing checked luggage and say, oh yay, I got a $400 ticket, but then you pay $140 for your checked bag, it might not be such a great price after all. So always make sure you're checking what your baggage fees will be based on what you think you're gonna bring and what you're gonna need. So that is Google Flights, a quick tutorial on how to use it basically, and also all of the secret hacks and tips that you can use to find the cheapest airfare. And it is the best website. If you're gonna pick just one website to use for booking all of your airfare, Google Flights is it. I, without end, always find the cheapest flights there. There's a few times I've found it cheaper elsewhere, but for the most part, Google Flights beats them all and is the best website to use for the cheapest airfare. Now, if you'd like to learn more of the secret tips and tricks for getting the cheapest airfare always, no matter what, go ahead and click this video here where I talk about my 5 secrets and hacks for always getting the cheapest airfare. I'm also gonna go ahead and link that below. And if you found this helpful, please go ahead and think about clicking that subscribe button. So I hope to see you on the next video, and I wanna wish you a great day and happy travels. Bye-bye.